Hello, I'm John McNamara, the Information Architect for IBM Messaging, and today I am here with a couple of legends from Hursley. Do you guys want to say who you are and what you do in Hursley?
I'm Steph Pugsley, I work for the IIB Docs, and I'm also the rep with L3 service to make sure all the customer service issues are represented in documentation.
Awesome. And yourself, Francesca?
Hi, I'm Francesca Menezes. I work for WebSphere Brand, doing social media and sales enablement.
Fantastic. So we are here to talk about IIB. Now, Steph, you've got some really interesting things to talk about. Do you want to walk us through? What those are? Have you got any new goodies for our listeners?
Right, so the current WebSphere message broker and IBM integration pack fixed pack schedule is averaging twice a year. As well as defect fixing and general improvements, there's also a lot of new functionality for each fixed pack release. The product documentation lists the enhancements in the What's New section, and there should be links at the bottom of this video to all the new sections. And we're going to talk about some of those new features now.
Awesome. So walk us through it.
Okay.
Bring it home, fella.
Yeah. So firstly, dealing with security, we have the integrated security enhancements for HTTP and SOAP nodes. Yeah. So you can now configure the HTTP nodes and the SOAP nodes to use integrated Windows authentication. IWA covers NTLM, Kerberos, and simple and protected negotiation. So in the documentation, we're going to talk about how you can authenticate incoming requests with IWA on Windows, Linux, and Unix. We give lots of examples using the NQSI change properties command to manage inbound support. It's important to read all this information because it discusses the fact that IWA requires the HTTP nodes and SOAP nodes use embedded integration server listeners instead of the broker-wide listeners, which you might already have. Mm-hmm. So we're also going to give guidance on how to switch from the broker-wide listener to an embedded listener. Of course, we also discuss how to consume IWA's secured service. You must use the HTTP request node and the SOAP request node, and IBM Integration Bus must be running on Windows at the moment. The documentation takes you through creating a security profile and gives lots of examples on using the NQSI change properties command to set up the outbound support for the NTLM, Kerberos, and the SPN EGO protocols.
That sounds awesome. One of the main focuses of IB is the message flows themselves. Is there anything in the message flow world that people pick up and play with?
Funny you should ask that, John.
Oh,
yes, we're now configuring the XPath cache for the message flows. For those customers who are using lots of XPath expressions, the integration server XPath cache size can become a big performance bottleneck.
Okay.
I meant to say a big performance bottleneck. An integration server keeps a cache of compiled XPath expressions to reduce the processor usage of having to parse and recreate the expressions that are used repeatedly during the message flow execution. And that default size is currently 100 elements. Mm-hmm. Because this cache is shared by all message flows in an integration server, the default size can easily become a performance bottleneck for customers with lots of XPath expressions. So now we can change that cache size, and in the docs we show you how to use the NQSI change properties command to change the size of the cache for your system.
What about other storage? But the database updates, can we look forward to that?
The SQL Server ODBC database drivers for Solaris on x86-64 systems, Microsoft SQL Server is now supported for Solaris on x86-64 systems. Mm-hmm. The documentation will give you instructions on remote access to an SQL Server, as well as sample ODBC configuration files for Solaris on x84-64.
Sweet. Now, a subject which is close to your heart, Steph, performance. So, bring it home. What's happening in performance? Tell us.
Okay. For high performance and scalability section, we now have a JNDI interface for the proxy servlet. So it used to be the case that the proxy servlet initialization parameters had to be configured for the broker environment that the proxy servlet is connecting to each time the proxy servlet was deployed. So naturally, lots of customers wanted to configure their new proxy servlet parameters one time only, and they wanted to do it through a JNDI. So now we have a new JNDI interface to configure the WebXML parameters, and then later you can deploy the proxy servlet as is and specify the JNDI resource name so the values can be all picked up. The documentation will talk you through that and any gotchas to look out for.
Sweet. Now that sounds awesome. All right, what about the API? Is there any API updates you can tell us about?
Okay, the integration service JavaScript client API. We can now support access to IBM Integration Bus functionality from browsers and cloud-based clients like Node.js. An integration service developer can generate a JavaScript client API from an existing integration service. So the JavaScript client API produces operation functions that a JavaScript developer can call from an application that is running in a JavaScript environment. So when the integration service developer generates a JavaScript client API for an integration service, the following events occur. Firstly, the JavaScript client API code is generated from the definition of the existing integration service interface. So you can use this code in JavaScript applications to call the integration service operations without configuring the underlying communication mechanism. A JavaScript method is created for the integration service operation.
Yes, Steph, you mentioned a bit about fixed packs releases at the beginning. Do they usually come out twice a year? Is that fairly standard for Broker?
Yeah, we aim for twice a year for Integration Bus simply because it gives customers time to integrate the new fixed pack before new functionality and new features and new work items and new defects are added. Anything more than twice a year, they're going to be overloaded. Anything less than twice a year, then maybe they're not getting the fixes that they need.
Just following on from that, you mentioned about the there being new fixes and improvements with each fixed pack release. So why are you adding new functionality?
Broker and IIB are, you know, they're organic living products, and the new functionality we add is based on customer feedback and things that the customer want to see. And so rather than waiting for a new manufacturing refresh or a new translation cycle or a new shipment cycle, we tried to get them out with a fixed pack, and the customers seem happy with that so far.
That sounds fantastic.
Great.
So guys, thank you so very much for popping along and doing this. It's been an absolute joy as always. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Bye.